wanted to accompany him. So he had to go back, and at Lanai Nathshala, he met Rupa and Sanatana Goswami and empowered them. After that, he came again all alone. The day he arrived in Vrindavan, that was the Sharad Purnima day of Kartik, the day when we start our Damodar Rath. At that time, this whole place was a big forest. Mahaprabhu used to stay in the night at Apurur Ghat, and during the day, he would come at Himli Thala. He would be completely absorbed in his in ecstatic mellows and thinking upon meditating, absorbed in the pastimes of Krishna. This is very nicely explained in Shri Chaitanya Charitamrita. Since that time only, these Goswamis have been celebrating the arrival festival of Mahaprabhu. From Bengal also some Vaishnavas come here. There is a big festival, Kirtan, and discussions of Mahaprabhu's glories. At their request, today we have also come here. I will explain briefly about Mahaprabhu, the reasons of Mahaprabhu's coming to this world. Who is Mahaprabhu? Before, and what is his glory? So many different incarnations have come in this world. He is the embodiment of all the different incarnations that came before him. What is the reason for his coming? He is very, very merciful. If he would have not come, then people would have thought that the Supreme Lord only exists in his Aishwarya form, in the form of Narayan, and that he is the only worshipable deity and the ultimate truth, and that Krishna is actually a manifestation of Narayan. People would have thought this if Mahaprabhu would not have come. Therefore, to show his mercy to the people of this world, Mahaprabhu came to establish that the Supreme Lord also exists in his Madhurya form, that he tastes all the different rasas, and he is the Ashrad, he is the Vishay of all those rasas. He could have also tasted all these mellows in Golok Dham. Then why did he come here? For the purpose, the reason he enacted his pastimes in this world was that the people could meditate upon those pastimes, and slowly, slowly meditating upon them and becoming purified, they would ultimately become qualified to enter into the pastimes of Krishna.
So, if Krishna has not come, or Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has not listened to Krishna, who would have think that all that? Krishna is the Supreme Personality of God, and he has all appearances, especially six appearances. But Krishna wanted to show that in love and devotion, I can be shunned of. I can be friend of anyone. Also I can be beloved. And thus I will serve them, my beloved, and my parents also, my friends also. If Krishna has not descended to this world, in Kutana, thought that something of personality of Godhead having so abundant and son of angel, or he can be beloved, or all the devotees like the other. So by worship Krishna, surely this, that I am son of God, I am friend of God, I am beloved of anyone, and I may be also beloved of. So to show this thing, I think Krishna descended to this world and given this message, especially Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Thank you.
Krishna himself, those who hear these kathas with great shraddha, with great faith, slowly, slowly all the unwanted desires, the anarthas, go away, and bhakti, bhakti naishiki, bhakti manifests within their heart, and finally they are able to enter in the pastimes of the Supreme Lord. Krishna is Raso Vaisava. He is the ocean of all the rasas. Still, even being the ocean of all the rasas, he manifested these pastimes and tasted the five rasas. He is the Vishaya of the five mellows, Dasya, Sakya, Shant, Dasya, Sakya, Vatsalya and Madhurya. Still, there was something that he was feeling missing within his heart. Radha Pranay Mahima. He is a Jagat Guru and he thought that there is no one, I am the most beautiful. Seeing my beauty, the entire world gets enchanted. But who is that who's seeing whose beauty I get enchanted? That's Srimati Radhika. I am the sweetest, but by whose sweetness I get also enchanted, that's Srimati Radhika. Hearing the sweet voice of my Venu, the world gets attracted. And similarly, hearing my sweet voice, the entire world gets enchanted. But hearing Radhika's sweet sound, my Venu also stops playing. And I also get overwhelmed. I am Asamodh Tattva. That is, there is no one greater than me. But here is this is a roundabout thought. Maharaj said this is a vichar which is opposite. He thought that there is something within me seeing which Radhika is enchanted. I get enchanted by her, but there must be something within me by which Radhika also gets enchanted. And she reaches the highest platform of Unmad and Param Prem Vaichitra. What is that sweetness, Madhurya, within me, because of which Radha Rani reaches that level, I am not able to understand. But there must be something within me, and the only way I can understand that is if by mercifully she gives me her half, so that I can understand what is within me which attracts her. Then Maharaj said that there were two other reasons for Mahaprabhu's arrival in this world. Second one is Karuna, that he is very, very merciful. Krishna, the service to Krishna is our goal. Our prayojan, our goal is neither Radha nor Krishna, but the love that is between Radha and the love that Radha has for Krishna, that is our goal. The love that makes both Radha and Krishna dance, that controls both of them, that enchanted by that love, Krishna also forgets who am I, and Radha Rani also forgets who she is. So this love is our goal. For to give this love only, Mahaprabhu came to this world to give this Rag, Anurag and Mahabhav to explain all these moons, to give all these moons to the people of this world, to establish the process of Rag-Marg. But this is still a secondary reason. The primary reason is still Radha Pranay Mahima, to understand the glories of Radha Pranay Bhav. Maharaj has said that to understand this, we will have to take another verse, Radha Pranay Vikrit Khalavani. I worship that form of Krishna. I worship Mahaprabhu, who is Krishna himself. Radha, who is Radha? She is a vikar of Krishna's pranay. Now transform into form of Rasgulla or Sandesh, its value increases. Narayan is saying that in Vrindavan, there is something called Khurchan, which is sold, and it is much more expensive than milk. Similarly, the transformation of Pranay, which is Rapa herself, is superior to Pranay also. She is Vrishbhanu Nandini, and she gives pleasure to Krishna, by which Krishna also gets control, becomes controlled by her and worships her. In order to relish all these moods, Mahaprabhu came here, but just like that, he was not able to relish. He first had to go to the school of Vishakha and Lalita and get trained. And where was the school? On the banks of Godavari. He discussed these matters, he asked questions from Raj Ramanand and was able to understand all these subject matters. Then when he was in Gambhira, he manifested all these transcendental meadows. Radharani also came in the form of Gadadhar Pandit, and she would always observe that Mahaprabhu, who has come taking her mood, if he is making any mistake in relishing her moods, and when he would make a mistake, she in the form of Gadadhar Pandit would correct him. And so I worship that Mahaprabhu. Now another question arises, that who came first? Did Mahaprabhu manifest first because he is Radha and Krishna combined, or Radha and Krishna separately, they exist first? So Maharaj is saying, both of them are simultaneously the absolute truth. They both exist simultaneously at the same time. If there is for manifestation, they are one in the form of Mahaprabhu, and for enacting their pastimes, they become two as Radha and Krishna, and Krishna himself is Mahaprabhu.
हम लोग का समय पूरा हो गया है, अभी वहाँ 6 बजे से हम लोग का प्रोग्राम चालू होने का है। आज ओडिशा होने वाला है, महाराज लोगों की वक्तृता भी होनी है, तो इसलिए संक्षेप में दो एक बातें बताऊंगा। कृष्ण से कुछ महापुण्य का राधा जी से भी महापुण्य का क्या होंगे इसी को हम कुछ साधारण रूप में राधा और कृष्ण दोनों मिलित हैं, इसलिए दोनों की मर्सी, दोनों की कृपा मिलित है, इसलिए महाप्रभु ने जगत के ऊपर की कृपा करके जो कृपा की राधा और कृष्ण अलग अलग होते हैं। कृष्ण ने रसा का आस्वादन किया, यहाँ तक कि दाताओं को भी प्रेम दिया, ये बात ठीक है, किंतु प्रेम को भाव करके दिया कांटे पर, एक छटा एक इधर उधर की नहीं, ये जैसा मात्र बदलते काम तो सुन गया, जो जैसा जिस रूप में हमारा भजन करता है, मैं भी उनका उसी रूप में प्रतिदान करता हूँ, किंतु चैतन्य महाप्रभु का आकर्षण ऐसा नहीं। कृष्ण प्रेम ऐसे जहाँ दूर दर्शन एवं दयालु प्रभु नहीं त्रिभुवन है, कृष्ण प्रेम जाना था। राधा कृष्ण भी जद्यपि ये विषय और आशय की परावर्ती है, ये बात ठीक है, किंतु यह परावर्ती और भी आगे बढ़ जाती है महाप्रभु के रूप में, श्री सचिदानंद जो सामने आ जाएगा उसी को प्रेम, चाहे बाप मालूम आ जाए, और जा रहे हैं महाप्रभु जी गाड़ी से बस से और उनके गोदी को उनके पैरों के स्पर्श से बाघ भालू और हाथी भी कृष्ण कृष्ण का ऐसा प्यार बहुत ये लोग बने करके नहीं पात्रता भी प्रदान करते हैं अपराधों को दूर भी कर देते हैं पात्र भी देते हैं अपराध साथ में ऐसे किए थे आप इसीलिए इनका विभाव आज का कृष्ण ने राग राग नहीं किया मैं तेरे भाव नहीं किया मना तो चल उसी हाथ का वो प्रभाव अधिक समय नहीं घटने के कारण से मैं संक्षेप में ये बता रहा हूँ माँ तुझे मैं तेरे भाव किया ये सभी भाव से भी जीवों के लिए अंक और और किसी उनके परिदर्श के रूप पर जाके ये ईश्वर बृहद व्याख्या करके बिशप और जीवों को संदेश दिया उन्होंने महाप्रभु के संदेश देने के लिए खुद और एक बड़ी भक्ति और स्वामी श्री गुरु की जय हम समझते हैं कि जो भारत में भी जो जिस विषय का देवी की जो कला है वो भारत उसमें कृष्ण हमेशा साधन करते हैं ये कलाएं हैं कुछ हैं उद्धव संदेश सरकार में
क्या
तो इस तरह से उन्होंने किया और एक और अनाथा तत्व को प्रकाशित किसने किया? राधा कृष्ण भी जाए और प्रेम न रहे और कृष्ण प्रेम श्री कृष्ण अपने आप जो कुछ नहीं जानते हैं उनके अंदर में भी इन भावों को जगत में जारी कर ऐसे महाप्रभु जी के महाप्रभु सबके मन के चरणों में आह्वान किया, निमंत्रित किया और हम लोग को सुजोग दिया कि उनके शरण ये हमसे अधिक विद्वान है और सब प्रकार से तत्व को जानने वाले तभी हमको उत्साहित करने के लिए उन्होंने ऐसा आयोजन किया और जब हम थोड़ा सा प्रचार करें इसलिए उत्साहित करेंगे।
Also said that one day will come when people in the Western world also disciple of Srila Prabhupada, he spread this message all over the world. But after he left, it slowly became it's lagging after he left. And Maharaj, in a very humble mood, is saying that I am who was as low as a straw of grass and very unqualified, by his mercy I am also doing some service by spreading this message. Another thing is that Krishna, he killed the demons, whether by his chakra or by strangulating someone like Putana. But in that life, those demons were not able to understand what their final destination was. After being killed by Krishna, what was their gati? For example, when Putana was killed, in that life she was not able to understand what gati she has obtained, what destination she has obtained. They could not realize the mercy of Krishna in the same life. But in the case of Mahaprabhu, the people he delivered in the same lifetime, they were able to realize his mercy like Gagai and Mathai. Also, what is Mahaprabhu? Mahaprabhu means Mahan Prabhu, the great Lord. He is the Lord of Lords. He is the Lord of Nityananda and Advaita. Who is Nityananda? Baldev, Lord Baldev. And Advaita is Shiva, Sadashiv, or Mahavishnu. And Mahaprabhu is the Lord of all of them. And therefore he is called Mahaprabhu. Maharaj also said another thing, that that person is called Mahaprabhu who gives love to the entire world in the greatest fashion. And this was done by Mahaprabhu, and that's why he is called Mahaprabhu. That's why he was also called Vishwankar. Krishna did not give Manjari Bhav, but Mahaprabhu gave, and he also manifested the Ramanand word. In his conversations with Ramanand, he clarified all the subject matters, that who is our Aradhya? Our Aradhya, as Maharaj explained before, is the love between Radha and Krishna. Even if we may attain Radha and Krishna, but if we don't have that love, then we are as good as Kans or Jarasandha. And that's why the love between them is more important. By attaining that love, Krishna also can be controlled. Mahaprabhu, in a very simple manner, explained these things and gave this name to the entire world. We pray again and again at his lotus feet that he kindly be merciful upon us. And we also pray to the very respected Sri Padmanabha Goswami for inviting us. Actually, we don't have any qualification, but by inviting us and giving us an opportunity to speak, he is encouraging us to spread this message all over the world. God bless you. Thank you.
All are waiting there. So, at once he is so rich there. And also, Ram is sitting there. He is God.
Where?
No, Rama.
Rama.
I don't know.
Maybe there is a name.